All champions think alike. I am a strong believer of what you desire, you can achieve. Remember, you can be a champion if you are 100% committed, you have conviction to win, and you are consistent in your approach. One can aspire for anything, absolutely anything, as I did once upon a time, when I was possibly just about 8 or 9 years old. I wanted to become the strongest man, and in 1991, I won the national championship in bodybuilding and became Mr. India 1991 title winner. If I can do it, you can do it too. I'm Aseem Mishra, and today I thought, let me share with all of you my journey of success to being a national champion. My takeaway has been, all champions think alike, 100%, irrespective of the sport they play. I resonate with all you champions listening to me right now. I remember my father, who exercised every day, narrated stories about several strong warriors from the epic Mahabharata. And I really got inspired by the warrior Bhim, who was known for his extraordinary strength. I told my father I wanted to be as strong as Bhim, and my journey of exercising started from then. Thereafter, the motivational letters from my father, who has been my hero all throughout, kept me marching forward with no looking back at all. I very clearly remember it was 26th of March 1991, and post completion of my workout, I was just about to leave, and just then my bodybuilding coach, Dr. Arun Datar, asked me to wait and said he would drop me off to the point from where I was going to proceed for the national championship. So I stopped, and soon he joined me and drove me down. On our way, there was pin drop silence in the car till the point he dropped me. As I stepped out of the car, he gave me rupees 100 and told me, "Aseem, keep this with you and call me once you have won the championship." And he left. I was shocked and frozen for a moment and did not realize what he said. Well, I just did not know how to and whom to react, as he had already left by then. I proceeded to Pune Railway Station, where I was required to join the Maharashtra bodybuilding team, which I was part of. The team manager soon joined us, since I was very junior and a fairly newcomer as compared to the other peer bodybuilders. The team manager began talking about each one of them and told me it takes years together to get to this level, and winning national championship is like only a dream, including for this team. Well, hearing this, I was not very happy, but for sure not deterred at all. This was so as me from within, I was sure the gold medal is mine and no one can take it away from me, as I had worked day and night to win this competition. And besides everything, yes, everything, I had full faith in my training and my beliefs. I did not say anything to him, but continuously kept stating to myself, the gold medal is mine and only mine. I knew I had trained all throughout the year, remembering that moment when I could not get any medal last year and had to come back empty-handed. The whole year, I kept reminding myself of that humiliation that I felt having not won any medal last year, and this year I only wanted gold medal. It was 29th of March 1991, the final day of competition. Early morning, the pre-qualifying rounds began, state-wise. It went on till late afternoon. There was a lot of nervousness all around. Of course, naturally, Millions of times the thoughts passed by, what if this, what if that? But then every nanosecond I kept reminding myself that, but the gold medal is mine. One statement I have been listening from my father always is that if you want to move forward, then you have to break the path behind so that there is no way you can roll back. Hence, there was only one way for me. The gold medal is mine. It was now evening of the 29th March 1991, the final day of competition, when top bodybuilders who cleared the prejudging round in the afternoon were called on the stage. And that was the moment, which was really a big, big achievement even to be a part of this lineup, as you are part of the top bodybuilders in the country. At this moment, while standing on the stage, I felt really thankful to the Almighty of giving me this opportunity to be part of this lineup. From the bottom of my heart, I felt thankful to my parents, my coach, my friends, and everyone who believed in my beliefs. Now, the picture of myself with that gold medal was only becoming brighter and brighter in my mind. The final elimination round of posing began with now only top 6 bodybuilders on the stage. Now was the 1 minute posing round. Yes, the final round. And in just 1 minute, your destiny would be decided as to who will be the top 3 winners of bronze medal, silver medal, and gold medal. Yes, I took a deep breath and was very sure of my gold medal. It was now the time of announcement of the winners, starting from 6th position, followed by 5th position, and so on, of course, excluding my name. I kept thanking to the Almighty all through. But when the winner of silver medal was announced, I started jumping across the stage. Seeing me, the winner of the silver medal, and everyone around me got confused as to why I was jumping around. Yes, by now I knew the gold medal was mine, as I had promised myself. Yes, soon I was declared the national champion, winner of Mr. India 1991 bodybuilding title. It's the desire backed by 100% dedication and discipline that makes a champion different from rest of the crowd. It's not about intensity, it's about consistency. In bodybuilding, you do not see change every day, for weeks together, sometimes even months. Most of the times, you get thoughts that nothing is happening. But this is the time to believe in your beliefs and keep progressing, as this is what brings the transformational change that begins to be visible to all around you and yourself. Your intense desire, discipline, and dedication becomes the game changer. It's all about attitude. Remember, champions are not born, but it's the attitude that makes them champions. Champions are people with very clear purpose. They know what they want, and they also know how to get what they want. The most important part of champions is they are very clear about their end goal, which is the result they aspire for. So, winning is about believing in your beliefs unquestionably, and most importantly, believing in your training. You can be a champion if you are 100% committed, you have conviction to win, and you are consistent in your approach, and no one can stop you from being a champion. All champions think alike. Thank you.